This session will help you in getting an overview about Agreement on Sanitary and Phytosanitary Regulations of WTO. Before we understand Agreement on Sanitary and Phytosanitary Regulations, we must understand what are sanitary and phytosanitary measures. SPS measures or sanitary and phytosanitary measures aims at ensuring safety of human, animal and plant life. These measures cover all aspects to protect animal or plant life or health from risks arising from the entry, establishment or spread of pests, diseases, disease-carrying organisms or disease-causing organisms. SPS measures also aims to protect human or animal life or health from risks arising from additives, contaminants, toxins, or disease-causing organisms in foods, beverages, or feedstuff. Objective of SPS measure is to protect human life or health from disease carried by animals, plants, or products thereof, or from the entry, establishment, or spread of pests. Under SPS measures, all steps are taken to prevent or limit damage from the entry, establishment, or spread of pests. Some examples of SPS measures are ensuring that animal and animal products coming from disease-free areas, inspection of products for microbiological contaminants, mandating a specific fumigation treatment for products, and setting maximum allowable levels of pesticide residue in food. Major objective of SPS regulations are to recognize the fact that all member nations have right to provide appropriate level of health protection to humans, animals, and plants, and also to ensure that SPS measures do not represent unnecessary, arbitrary, scientifically unjustifiable, or disguised restrictions on international trade. Further, SPS agreement allows countries to set their own food safety and animal and plant health standards, provided that such regulations are based on science and that these measures are applied only to the extent necessary to protect health, and they do not discriminate between countries where identical or similar conditions prevail. SPS agreement encourages members to use international standards, guidelines, and recommendations where they exist. However, members may adopt SPS measures which result in higher level of health protection or measures for health concerns for which international standards do not exist, provided that they are scientifically justified. An SPS measure which is not actually required for health reasons can be a very effective protectionist device, and at times it becomes difficult to challenge such barriers due to their technical complexity. Key provisions of SPS agreement are to ensure that members have the right to adopt SPS measure to achieve their self-determined health protection level. This level is also called the appropriate level of protection, or ALOP, or the acceptable level of risk. One of the important provisions of SPS agreement is harmonization, according to which members are encouraged to base their measures on international standards, guidelines, and recommendations where they exist. This facilitates establishment, recognition, and application of common SPS measures by different members. To ensure that there are uniform international standards, SPS agreement recognizes three international standard setting bodies, also known as three sister organizations. First one is Codex Alimentarius Commission, which is responsible for providing food safety measures, standards, and guidelines. It was established in November 1961 by the Food and Agricultural Organization and was joined by World Health Organization in June 1962. Second organization established in 1924 is Office International des Epizooties, which addresses measures related to animal health. Last one is Secretariat of International Plant Protection Convention. It sets norms for measures related to plant health. Needless to mention that members who base their measures on guidelines set by these three international organizations can be confident of their compliance with the SPS agreement. The process of harmonization is monitored by the SPS committee in cooperation with the three sister organizations. Article 3 and Article 5 of the SPS agreement permits members to adopt SPS measures which are more stringent than the relevant international standards, or adopt SPS measures when international standards do not exist, provided that these measures are based on scientific risk assessment, consistently applied, and are not more trade restrictive. Another important provision under SPS agreement is consistency. The consistency requirement under the agreement means that member must avoid unjustifiable differences in the level of health protection if such differences result in discrimination or a disguised restrictions on international trade. For example, if a member restricts the importation of one animal product because of disease risk, yet allows the importation of other animals presenting identical or similar risk, there would be a concern that the objective may be protectionism and not health protection. SPS agreement permits applying provisional measure where there is insufficient scientific evidence to permit a final decision on the safety of a product or process. For example, provisional measure can be taken as an emergency response to a sudden outbreak of an animal disease suspected of being linked to imports. SPS agreement recognizes that more than one SPS measure may be equally effective in satisfying a country's appropriate level of protection. Importing members may accept as equivalent the SPS measure of an exporting member if the exporter objectively demonstrates that its measures achieve the importer's appropriate level of protection. Let's take an example to understand the concept of equivalence. In 1994, the Scientific Veterinary Committee, Animal Health of European Commission published a document considering the heat treatment of milk originating from foot and mouth disease affected areas. The publication recommended specific heat treatment that could be applied to potentially infected milk to destroy the FMD virus. Whereas New Zealand operated a policy of only accepting dairy product from countries that had been free from FMD for at least 12 months. During negotiation on a New Zealand EC veterinary agreement in 1996, it was agreed that New Zealand would undertake a risk analysis of dairy product and that EC would provide information to support their position on accepting dairy product from countries with FMD. New Zealand completed the risk analysis in early 1998 and adopted a similar position to the EC. One of the key goals of the SPS agreement is to increase the transparency of sanitary and phytosanitary measures. Therefore, governments are required to notify other countries of any new or changed SPS measure which affects trade. They also have to set up offices called inquiry points to respond to requests for more information on new or existing measures. Inquiry points for agreement on SPS regulations in India are Department of Agriculture and Cooperation for Plant Protection, Ministry of Health for Food Safety, Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairy for Animal Health Product, Department of Agriculture and Cooperation. I hope this video helped you in understanding the basic provisions under agreement of sanitary and phytosanitary measures. For more details, you can connect with me at alkamya@gmail.com. Keep watching for more such videos on various agreements of WTO. Thank you.